A word now that some groups supporting Hillary Clinton are organizing to try and weaken Donald Trump ahead of his anticipated showdown with Mrs. Clinton in the general election. Among their plans, trying to discredit Mr. Trump's business background with voters and organizing anti-Trump rallies at the Republican National Convention this summer in Cleveland and marches in major cities. Karine Jean-Pierre is a Democratic strategist, and Ian Pryor is a Republican strategist and communications director for American Crossroads. Thank you both for joining us.
Hi, Heather.
So, Karine, I'll start with you. Will this work? It hasn't worked so far from Republicans.
Great question, Heather. Well, the first thing that I have to say is don't bark. No more barking. If you have to bark, do it in private. Certainly do not do it in public. Look, when it comes to Donald Trump, you have to play by the rules of the playground. Do what your mother told you to do, right? When a bully makes fun of you, you just walk away and leave the bully there standing looking silly. Democrats will lose if they play a race to the bottom. They will. You know, if we go and call him a womanizer, he's going to call her an enabler. You go and attack his labor practices, he's going to come back and say she's collecting money by warlords. So we just can't do tit for tat at all.
So Ian, why do you think that they're doing this? Because that's actually already happened. They already tried to come after Trump, specifically with women, and he came back even harder.
Yeah, well, I think it shows that despite some of the bluster that you're hearing from Democrats, they really are scared of a Donald Trump candidacy. Look, he's bringing out voters that we haven't seen since, you know, well before 2008. I think turnout is up 7 million amongst Republicans and down 4 million amongst Democrats. And Hillary Clinton has had a really tough week. And I think they see a vulnerability in Hillary, especially in some of these purple states, states that may not even have thought to be in play before, like Pennsylvania and Michigan and maybe Wisconsin, where Donald Trump is speaking to working class voters and Hillary Clinton just isn't.
So, Karine, you were saying that this would not work, this type of strategy. What type of strategy would work, and do you think that they are really concerned about Donald Trump?
Yes, I think we should be concerned about Donald Trump, most definitely, absolutely. Look, you know, he's so unpredictable that he's becoming predictable. I think the playbook here is to not play by his rules, and we have to figure out how to ignore him and really talk about the issues, but not play by his rules.
And Ian, one of the things that they said they are going to do is talk about the issue, specifically some of his business dealings. Do you think that they actually have some information that they would not have used so far, like they claim?
Yeah, well, I really
I'm not really sure about that. But what I do see is what issues they're going to talk about. I mean, Hillary Clinton is all over the place on the issues. You know, she was for TPP, now she's against TPP. She was for NAFTA, now she's against NAFTA. She was adamantly against illegal immigrants, and now she's hoping that they'll all someday be able to vote for her. The bottom line with Hillary Clinton, at this point, it looks like, you know, she was built in a polling firm in a basement in Washington, D.C. She has no strong convictions. The only conviction she has is what her consultants tell her to do that'll get her elected to be president. And it's going to be tough to draw a contrast with Donald Trump when you don't have strong convictions of your own.
This does seem to be the year of the anti-establishment, and Karine, she's been in Washington. She worked with President Obama. She was, you know, part of Washington when Bill Clinton was in Washington. How does she escape that? Is it just the negative ads against Trump that will differentiate her?
Well, look, the Republicans are also going to be splintered. There was a recent polling that showed likely Republican voters are trying to decide, 800 likely Republican voters are trying to decide whether they're going to vote for, 20%, I should say, are trying to decide if they're going to vote for Trump or Hillary Clinton. They're still unclear. And so I think there is an issue there for the Republicans as well as having Trump as their nominee.
Yeah, but there are also plenty of Democrats or Republican-leaning Democrats and also independents who are crossing over and considering Trump. An example specifically is the state of Ohio where that happened. So do you think that some of these ads would push some of those voters, specifically independents, which will count heavily in this latest general election? 40% of people claim to be independent. Do you think it would push some of those people in favor of Trump because of the negative ads?
I hope so. I mean, that's the hope. I mean, the last 6 months, there hasn't been a lot of strong attacks, negative attacks on Trump. We kind of let that go. The Republicans let that go for a very long time. So now we got to refocus, you know, settle, you know, really focus on Trump and go negative on him, these outside groups that are clearly mm-hmm. supporting Hillary Clinton. And we need to do that. There's no other way to do it. She can't do it. She can't do it at all. But the outside groups can. So
Ian,
we'll see.
Yeah, Ian, do you think this could benefit the other two who are still in the race, either Kasich or Cruz?
Well, I'm not really sure because thus far, you know, several have tried to attack Trump and all have failed. So I'm not really sure that someone attacking Trump from the left is going to help, you know, his opponents in the Republican primary. What I will say is there haven't been a whole lot of negative ads on Hillary Clinton. Bernie Sanders has not laid a glove on Hillary Clinton. He's done soft contrast ads. Think about some of the things she said recently. We're going to put coal companies out of business. You know, Eastern Ohio, Western Pennsylvania, that's not going to play very well. And you combine that with her anti-fracking stance, people are going to be paying $300 a month electric bills. So those are some negative ads that Donald Trump may be able to use to get at her in some of these important swing states.
But the goal, Karine, you're saying, would be for these super PACs or these other groups to present those ads to keep their candidate, Hillary, directly out of the fray.
That's right.
All right.
That's right. That's right.
Thank you both for joining us. Karine, Ian, have a great weekend.
Thank you. You too.
And
thank
still.
You.